we've talked about basic audio routing. If you just wanted to use your headphone jack to get the audio out of Ableton Live and into your sound system. And the headphone jack, though, only gives you two outputs. You've got the click and the cues on the left, and you've got all your tracks on the right. Now, what happens, though, if you want more outputs? If you want stereo outputs, or maybe you want to send every instrument out of its own output, how do we do that? So we have a diagram at Loop Community. If you just go to our training center, and what you can do is you can actually, instead of using your headphone jack, you could plug in an external audio interface, like a Personas interface, or iConnect, or Focusrite. And these interfaces are USB or Thunderbolt, and what they do is they give you more outputs than just two. So in this diagram, this interface actually gives you eight outputs. You plug it in, and then you would send all the different outputs to different direct boxes to your sound system. And then your front of house guy, your mixer, he can adjust the volume of the levels instead of you doing it inside of Ableton Live. So that can be really helpful to make sure you get a good mix of all your tracks. So in Ableton Live, all you do is in the bottom right corner, click on the little button that says I/O. I/O stands for In-N-Out, not the burger place. But if you open up In-N-Out, it opens up all the In-N-Out settings for each channel. Now it looks a little confusing. The top boxes are for audio inputs. So if we were actually recording into Live, then those would be helpful for us. But for this, we're looking for where the audio is going. And that's the little box at the bottom that says audio to. Right now it says that all of my tracks are going out of the master. And the master is over here on the right-hand side of the screen. And right now it says the master is going out one and two. Now all you do is you plug in your interface, and then you would change these to external out, and then choose the output on your interface that you want. If you had an interface plugged in that had 16 outputs, then you would see 16 different outputs listed here. So that's a way you would go through every single instrument and change it to the different outputs that you want. What's also helpful is maybe you want to group the tracks together. So let's just say you have a group of tracks here that are all guitars. I could go ahead and rename these to guitar one and then guitar two. If I want to group these together, I can highlight them like this, holding command, right click, go to group, and then I can call this guitars. And you can set the output of the guitar group by just changing it to external out here and then the output you want. So that's a way that you can kind of customize and do audio routing in a more advanced way to really make it better for your sound guy and to really help your mixes. Hope that helps.